billions before you have died, and billions after you will die too. It's a fact of life. Our Earth is effectively one big graveyard for generations that lived before us. But what happens to all of these people after they're gone? Hello and welcome back to Life's Biggest Questions. I'm Rebecca Felgate, and today we're asking, what happens to our bodies after we die? In this day and age, people make plans surrounding their deaths, and as graveyards fill up to maximum capacities, a lot of people opt to be incinerated after death and have their ashes either scattered or stored in some way. To answer this question fully, we're going to discuss the full process of bodily decomposition. As a person dies, the muscles in their body contract, which can mean that bodily fluids, including urine and feces, are dispelled. In the moments after we take our last breath, our body begins to enter something called alga mortis. This is where blood and subsequently the body cools down to room temperature. This will be why dead people are often described as being cold. After alga mortis, the body enters the rigor mortis stage, which is where the blood begins to congeal. During rigor mortis, the body becomes very stiff and difficult to move. Rigor mortis is one of the first signs of decomposition. It would be around this time that funeral parlors would refrigerate or embalm the body to slow down the effects of death. This would be ahead of a scheduled funeral date, especially those with open caskets. However, once again, we are going to be approaching this question from a natural standpoint. The first stage of human decomposition is called autolysis, and is kind of a process of self-digestion. This begins immediately after death. As the blood coagulates, the body is unable to circulate oxygen like it is when the heart is beating. The excess carbon dioxide in the body causes cell membranes to rupture, which then releases enzymes that begin to eat the cells. During this time, cells begin gradually dying off. If a person is an organ donor, organs have to be removed before this process starts, so within the first 30 minutes of death. The bacteria released during this process causes skin discoloration. At first, a person's body will appear green, then purple during the bloating stage. Bloating will begin as enzymes present produce gases. Often during this time, a body can double in size. During this stage, eyes are pushed out of their sockets and tongues are pushed out of mouths. Further fluids will also seep out of eyes and mouths. This is arguably the most unpleasant part of death, as this is not only when a body becomes discolored and bloated, it is also when the body starts giving off a very unpleasant smell. This smell is part of putrefaction. This is often why in movies people are portrayed as smelling something very off and then finding a body, or finding a body and covering their noses. Animals are able to smell a decomposing body. This would be the time that flies and other insects would eat bodies and lay eggs. If maggots are present, they can consume 60% of a human body in fewer than 7 days. Some say that hair and nails grow after a person dies. However, this is a visual effect attributed to the scalp and cuticle shrinkage. Several weeks after death, nails and teeth will fall out. The rate and effects of decomposition on a body totally depend on where the body is left after death. If a body is put in water, it will decompose at half the rate as a body left on land. Decomposition is slowest underground, as the bacteria that decays a body require oxygen. This is why some bodies can look totally preserved over time if left in the right conditions, for example in clay. Preserved bodies will become leathered from dehydration, but unpreserved bodies will burst open and ooze, eventually leaving just the skeleton. It is also important to note that even embalmed bodies will decay too, just at a slower rate. If left unattended, skeletons will also eventually decay. As they say, ashes to ashes and dust to dust. So what happens after we die? Well, the second the lights go out, we start to decompose and the rest isn't pretty. The circumstances and environment of death are huge factors on the initial rate of decay, as is post-death treatment. Mostly though, unless you're cremated or mummified, in the end it's kinda gooey. Ugh. Body farms exist across the world to study decomposition rates in humans, with many variables introduced to understand environments and their effect. Ultimately, once you're gone, there isn't too much point worrying about what happens to your body. It would be my personal choice that my organs were donated and had the chance to live on while saving someone else's life, but of course that is a much bigger debate. So that is one big question with one big answer for you. If you want to continue the discussion, please feel free to do so in the comment section down below. For now, if you want to be the first to hear an answer, make sure you have clicked on that notification button. Thank you guys for tuning into this video. I'm Rebecca Felgate, and I will see you next time. For now, stay curious, stay alert, and never ever stop questioning.